So students, let's take up differentiation of trigonometric functions. As we have just now discussed, the direct differentiation formulas for algebraic differentiation as well as some examples based on it. Now I'll give you some direct formulas which are used for trigonometric differentiation or differentiation of trigonometric functions. We all know that there are 6 trigonometric ratios of which we can directly define the differentiations, which will directly apply in various cases, like if y is given as sin x, you just keep in mind in this situation dy by dx is cos x. Right now you are not bothered about how the result is coming. You just need to keep these results on your tips to be applied on various cases. Second, if you are given with y is equals to cos x, in this case dy by dx is given as minus sin x. If you are given with y is equals to 10x, then dy by dx in this case is written as sec square x. Fourth, if you are given with y is equals to cot x, then in this case dy by dx is written as minus cosec square x. And if y is given as sec x, then dy by dx is written as sec x tan x. And the last one, direct differentiation formula for trigonometric function is for cosec x. In this situation, dy by dx is written as minus cosec x cot x. So these 6 relations, direct relations for trigonometric differentiation, you need to keep on your tips. Let's discuss some examples where we use all these relations. Let's take an example. If we are given with y is equals to 10x plus x cube, and we are required to find dy by dx. In this situation, again we directly apply all the relations which we have studied. This is basically a mixed function which involves trigonometric function as well as an algebraic function. Here we can directly write dy by dx. For 10x the differentiation is sec square x. For x cube we can directly use the formula x to power n. That becomes n x to power n minus 1, this is 3x square. So this will be the answer to the question. Directly we need to apply the result. Another example, if we just have a look, say we are given with y is equals to sin x plus cot x plus 5x to power 4. And again we are required to find y prime. Here y prime we can directly write by using the direct differentiation formulas. For sin x it is cos x. For cot x it is minus cosec square x. And for 5x to power 4, obviously it will become 20x to power 3. This is the answer. Say one more example we'll take up. If we are given with y is equals to sec x plus 1 upon 5x square, and we are required to find dy by dx. In this situation, if we directly apply the result, dy by dx will be, for sec x direct differentiation formula is sec x tan x, and for 1 by x square it will be x to power minus 2. So it will become minus 2 by 5 x to power minus 3. This is the answer. You can also write it 2 by 5 x cube. Let's see one more example. If we are given with y is equals to sin x plus 10 x, and we are required to find dy by dx. Here you can see, and the value of dy by dx can again be given by direct formulas. For sin x the direct differentiation is cos x, plus for tan x direct differentiation is sec square x. This is the answer. It's quite simple. If you are able to just recall what direct formulas you have studied, you can directly apply. Like if you are given with y is equals to 7x to power 8 plus sec x, and we are required to find dy by dx. In this situation, again we use the same relation. dy by dx is given as 7x to power 8 becomes 56x to power 7 plus sec x 10x. This will be your answer. For another example, if you are given with y is equals to 7x to power 4 plus 3x to power 5 plus cot x plus cos x, and we are required to find y prime. Again, just as an application of direct formulas, we use it. It will become 28x to power 3 plus 15x to power 4 minus cosec square x minus sin x. This will be the answer. I hope now students, all of you can practice well about any type of questions based on direct differentiation formula of algebraic as well as trigonometric differentiation.